Hey guys, so today we're going to talk about something that might be very close to your hearts. The poem dedicated to beloved and mighty Hindu god Hanumanji, the Hanuman Chalisa. Over the past many years, there's been speculation that Hanuman Chalisa correctly calculates the distance to the sun, centuries before modern science even evolved. Something that sure sounds very exciting, but is it true though? Let's try to find out in this video. Before starting this discussion, let me say it categorically. This video is just a journey of a seeker trying to find the truth. This in no way means to malign or insult any sentiments. In fact, I believe seeking the truth would only honor the Vedic sciences and Vedic scientists, like say for example Aryabhatta. So there are like two beliefs when it comes to this particular topic. One says it correctly states the distance to the sun. And the scientific side, which is skeptical of this, argues against it. I often hear this argument that how can a religious text show a scientific calculation? Now, I believe it is a rather shallow way of looking at things. Science isn't just something that is defined by written human rules. Humans do not even know precisely how many dimensions are there in the universe, let alone the understanding of philosophy and metaphysics. Science is an ever-evolving, ever-changing study of reality itself. Also, we do not even know how people thought in ancient times. Maybe, just maybe, they expressed scientific values through religious texts. Scientific community should be more open-minded than that. But does that mean that Hanuman Chalisa correctly depicts the distance between Earth and the Sun? Well, the answer is complicated to say the least, as it should be in the real studies of science. So we are talking about this verse in particular. Juk sahasra jojan par bhanu lilyo tahi madhur phal janu. Goswami Tulsidas writes in 16th century where he mentions an episode from Hanumanji's childhood. He says Hanumanji was so mighty that he jumped towards the sun, thinking of sun to be a ripe mango. Bhanu being the sun, Jug is yuga, which is equal to 43,20,000 human years or 12,000 divine years or god years. Sahasra equals to 1,000, yojana is 8 miles. So the basic calculation is 12,000 into 1,000 into 8 is equal to 96 million miles or 153.6 million kilometers. Earth revolves around the sun in an elliptical orbit, and the distance between Earth and the sun varies between 147.1 to 152.1 million kilometers. So yay, that would mean Hanuman Chalisa did actually calculate the distance with only a marginal error. Not actually, because this calculation is based on two assumptions. That by yuga, Tulsidas meant 12,000 divine years, and by yojana, he meant 8 miles. Now what are divine years and where does this number 12,000 come from? Let's look at this diagram first. We have two equinoxes and two solstices during a whole year. On equinoxes, the Earth is placed in a way that the rotation of Earth is almost perpendicular to the Sun. And that means almost equal day and night on both equinoxes in March and September. While on solstices, Earth is placed in a way that in Northern Hemisphere, where India is located, we have longest day on summer solstice and longest night on winter solstice. Let's go to Mahabharata, Shanti Parv, chapter 231, text 12 to 20. Here it is stated that one day of the gods is equal to one whole year of humans. How so? The daytime of gods is from equinox in March to the equinox in September, which has the summer solstice in between or the longest day. The nighttime of the gods is from equinox in September to the equinox in March, which has the winter solstice in between or the longest night. Thus, one god's day is equal to a whole human year. And 360 of such god's days make one god year. So one god year is equal to 360 human years. Here it is also mentioned that Krita Yuga or Sat Yuga is 4800 god years, Treta Yuga is 3600 god years, Dwapar Yuga is 2400 god years, and Kali Yuga is 1200 god years. So the total cycle of these yugas come to 12,000 god years. And by simple calculation, 12,000 into 360 is 43,20,000 human years. Bhagavad Gita chapter 8 verse 17 also verifies this exact number of yugas. So now we know where this number 12,000 exactly comes from. Now let's get back to the calculation in Hanuman Chalisa. The question arises as to why do we assume the whole cyclic number of all four yugas and not just one yuga in that particular calculation? And why did we assume God's years and not human years, which would be 43,20,000? Also, there is a discrepancy when it comes to number of years in yugas if we refer to Brahmand Puran or Linga Puran. So how do we know which definition of yuga was Tulsidas referring to? This is the question we need to be asking. As now you know the assumption we have made when we used 12,000 in that particular calculation. Now let's talk about Yojana. Throughout ancient texts, there are discrepancies as to what the value of Yojana is, be it ancient Buddhist texts or texts from King Ashoka. The value varies from 5 to 8.5 miles. If you want me to make a separate video on Yojana, please let me know in the comments below. So it does look like we assumed Yuga to be 12,000 and a Yojana to be 8 to fit the calculation. At least until we find some hard evidence of Tulsidas's calculation, we cannot just prove that these are the numbers he meant in that verse. That being said, it would be naive to just call this calculation an error, especially when there's been a lot of ancient Indian literature that includes science has been lost in history or are yet to be discovered. So what's the conclusion we can derive from this? We must be seekers of knowledge and keep on researching. This is how we can move closer to conclusion. That's it for this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and do subscribe for more such videos. Thank you guys.